sure nobody expected. But that's what I do. Y'all know me.
Hello, this is Cassidy, here to play some Drake of the 99 Dragons on the Bad Game Hall of Fame. Or, since it's seasonal, since it is the Halloween season, someone tweeted at me earlier today, Andrew Jack tweeted at me, our Halloween name for the month, which is, Boo Games Hella Flames! What if I spoke like this for the entire playthrough? Ooh! This would never get old! Okay, I think that's enough of that. And we're gonna hop into Drake and the 99 Dragons here. For those of you who don't know, this is a video game featuring Drake, he of the 99 Dragons, on his quest to avenge the clan of the 99 Dragons. And he's got 99 Dragons on his side, and to have mentioned there's dragons in this, and Drake. I wrote an article about this game. You may have seen it mentioned in a little website called PC Gamer, where they addressed me as the number one Drake fan, the president of the Drake of the 99 Dragons fan club. The president, only member as well, but, you know, we're hoping to invite some more people. Hopefully after today's stream, we'll get some new recruits, we'll get some fresh meat in here, some warm blood, and, you know, really get this whole cult going. Not a cult, fan club. Big difference between the two, legally speaking. We're going to be playing this on PC. Now, as mentioned, as alluded to, I am a fan of this game. I am genuinely a fan of this game and its offerings. And I will be happy to answer questions in the chat about this game. I did manage a interview with one of the QA testers who had a lot of insight into this game, which I was very happy about. And I think I uncovered some details that maybe were not covered by all the gaming press, some things that get sort of willfully ignored. But I think the game can really speak for itself. I think if we come into this with no conceptions, no prior notions, if you open your heart to Drake and let the 99 Dragons in, well, we'll see where your heart takes you. We're going to start this off. We're going to do the tutorial missions, even though they're a little long. But, you know, we're going to miss out on some cutscenes if we don't do it. And I will let the cutscenes play through for those of you who maybe haven't seen them. But, yeah, here goes nothing.
Those who know my name whisper it in fear. Most people I meet, I only meet once. I am Drake, the assassin. To me, life is all about death.
That's our hero, ladies and gentlemen. Introducing a killer. Now, I was going to do this thing where, like, all the mission text and mission titles are actually in a text file, in a raw text file you can edit, and I was going to do funny stuff with the titles and the descriptions, but I didn't get around to it. This is Drake, and I want to, before we get too far, get close up. You can see he actually has pupils in his eyes, that his model here is a little different than it will be for the majority of the game. There are some changes that were made to the character model. There's some unique Drake models here. This tutorial does take a little long to actually get going for it to pop up the next message, so let me just get my sea legs back. Of course, people were mentioning that the Xbox version of this game is more rightfully sort of made fun of, more rightfully jeered and mocked, especially by one Adam Sessler of X-Play. Oop, I already did the thing where I accidentally... Ah, there we go. You're not supposed to be able to only hold one gun at once. You're supposed to be dual-wielding all the time, guns akimbo. There's a lot of little details in this first level that I kind of like. All the holes and the light peeking through and whatnot. There's some weird little nice touches to this game that get completely overlooked by just about everyone except me. The president of the Drake of the 99 Dragons fan club. We're going to play through this entire game, by the way. It should only take me about an hour and a half, I think. That's going to be my conservative guesstimate. You're seeing here how we, this version of the game has the mouse aiming, as opposed to the Xbox version, which is all auto-aiming all the time, to where your arms are flailing about wildly. I can't even really emulate that on the PC version, because it is all manual aiming, which is for the best. Give me more control, letting you actually select which enemy you want to shoot under. Okay. It's been a while since I actually played the tutorial mission here. Usually you can just jump right into the third mission of the game, which for the main menu reads as new game, no tutorial. And you get to skip these first two missions. Sean AB, I will try to do it in under an hour. I don't think I can do it in under an hour. Nope, I actually got hit twice there. This is a little tutorial thing where I need to collect all these banners. Where's the fourth one? Hot dang. Oh, there it is. Yeah, all I need to do is touch this and we should be good. Move right on to the second one. As soon as the mission complete pops, there we go.
We at Tang Industries are proud manufacturers of the reanimated cyborg, a technological and spiritual wonder. A Tang cyborg is neither man nor machine, and won't make the mistakes of either.
I wonder what Master has prepared this time.
Has someone close to you recently departed? Tang Industries pay families to donate the bodies of their departed loved ones. Contact us today!
Skills are sufficient, but pale when compared to my master's. I must whet my edge against new stones. A Tang cyborg?
Yeah, sorry the audio mixing might not be great. I wish I had like an auto-duck thing that I could do on the fly where it would duck my commentary and game audio and adjust them accordingly. But also the cutscenes are mixed a little low. Because you hear like how loud the gunfire is here compared to cutscene audio and the gunshot peaks are pretty loud, so I wanted to make sure that we're just erring on the side of caution here. It'd be nice if this game had subtitles. Which, just to answer your question, Codeman, no, this game does not have subtitles, unfortunately. If it did, I would absolutely turn them on, because I always prefer to have subtitles. Any minute now, there we go. Okay, we can get into the game proper now. This cutscene's gonna explain more of the story. I hope you're all picking it up. You know, this, the general premise is that we live in some sort of cyber future where this Tang Industries mega conglomerate makes these robots and put actual human souls into the robots. And we'll see how that plays out later in the story.
Strange thing about the cyborg. A machine. Yet I sensed presence inside it. A soul? Oh, what was that?
Intruders in the penthouse of the 99 Dragons clan? You must be out of this world to get past our guards. I'm of seat to the master, and the soul portal artifact. Rumors say Tang is hunting for it. It was given to our clan over 3,000 years ago. We've guarded it since, and we're not going to lose it now.
What's interesting in these cutscenes is that you see Drake already has like the full white eyes with no pupils. That's actually a bit of a continuity error, as I'll address in a bit.
This theft can't be Tang's doing alone. He must have aid from beyond this world.
The artifact, it can't be gone. We were to protect it.
Are we going to fail?
So you saw in the first, in the tutorial missions, that we had the pupils in the eyes, and if you read the comic, which there is one issue of a comic book that accompanies this release, you'll see that when Drake starts off, he is a normal human to begin with, like a very skilled assassin, but still human. And then when he becomes inhuman, he loses the pupils and gets the Batman-looking eyes. Speaking of which, look at these two corpses over here. That's very curious. I'm sure that one on the right, the one closest to us, is us. That definitely won't be a point in the story that gets addressed. That'll definitely be completely ignored. This might well be the hardest mission in the game, if only because you can't recover health as you play it, and because the positions of some of these enemies can be a bit difficult. So we might actually die in this mission a couple times, but after this it should be smooth sailing, I believe. We also don't have, like, our full suite of abilities yet. We can't do the wall run. We can only do our standard double jump. So I'm playing this because, one, I like it and I just want any excuse to play it. And two, I know the nerd, the one who gets angry at the video games, I know he played it recently. I finally just got around to seeing that review. And, you know, I can't disagree with the assertion that this game is not great in a lot of ways, but hey, I like it. I've stood up for it before, and I will stand up for it again. And yes, there is a very Wilhelm-sounding scream that gets reused a few times in this game. You notice a lot of the sound effects are just stock sound effects. Like, doors opening is literally the AOL Instant Messenger door opening sound effect, which is just choice. And especially in some of the upcoming levels, there's a lot of really low, crushed bitrate samples that you'll hear in city streets and whatnot.
Out of this world, that is. Almost ghost-like. What kind of demons are we up against? If there is unrest in the spirit world, Master will know. Master? Me? This can't be! All dead! And I... the tattoo! No!
Drink, and you'll be strong.
That's the secret to immortality!
Bitter.
That's an X-Play reference from, like, 15 years ago.
Master.
Do not fear. You can hear, but are unable to move. The time has come. I will forge the Undying Dragon on your chest. It is our legacy. The Undying Dragon is a sentient creature unto itself that bestows supernatural powers upon its bearer. Powers that will make you last beyond death.
No! I will have revenge.
Okay, so here's where the game really opens up. We have to suffer through this mission, which is just a rehash of the same exact map we played on previously, but now we have our abilities with us, including wall running, which you can chain together in some pretty ridiculous ways. We can also do our slow-mo because the Matrix was a thing. And our mission here is to collect 30 of these souls, and I think I know the ideal way to get them, the quickest way to get them. Hold on. Oh man, I guess I am a little more rusty than I initially envisioned. I didn't prepare, I didn't practice for this. But you know, I have most of this game committed to memory, committed to my heart, so... yes, this was 2003. You could say PS1-esque rendering. I don't know, I feel like it's a little ungenerous. It's definitely stylized, or trying to go for that whole comic book aesthetic thing. You know, the comic book, by the way, had some pretty decent art to it, had a pretty decent little style lined up for it. I would have liked to have seen the continuing adventures of Drake, as cliche as they may be. Missed opportunity here. You know, you wish that you had a little more time to put this game in the oven and get stuff done, but they already lie about how long the game took to develop as is. You'll hear claims from Idle Effects developers that the game took 6 months to create, but that is demonstrably untrue, as the QA tester I interviewed would attest to, who said that by the time he joined the game with 6 months of time spent, you know, like, left of QA, that so much of the game was already done, that would be unfathomable to believe that the game had not, like, been in the oven already, had not been a work in progress up to that point, that had not already had several months of development before that point. So, you have to take Idle Effects at their word. There are also the people who brought us that Nosferatu FPS, which I actually quite like as well. I think that game is really underrated, one of the underrated horror games of our sort of console generation. Or not console generation, because it was PC only. And it was also 2002 or 2003, so... Okay, I see the point you're making, Video Game, where his mouth was just not animating. Yeah, that's a fair complaint, I would say. And you see how generous of it is with the time in this mission. I think it gives a whole 15 minutes that we are absolutely not going to need to use. And don't worry if this mission's a little bit boring, because the next mission we'll hop into If this is a mission where the game opens up, the next mission is where it picks up and we get into more non-stop wall jumping 99 dragon action. And by the way, here is the best cutscene in the game. It's all downhill from here.
The strength of the stolen souls is changing me. Have I become invincible? Nothing can stop me now. Fool! Obviously the undying dragon does not protect him from his stupidity.
More of this and he'll go from undead to just plain dead.
What is this?
The Serene Garden. Your stop between reality and the afterworld. Better get used to it. You'll keep coming back until you've mastered the way of the dragon.
The legacy? Weren't you supposed to make me invincible?
He disappoints us.
How could I avenge the Master's death?
Make it your priority to feed the undying dragon souls, and you'll have your revenge.
What about the soul portal artifact?
Your ghost is about to complete its mission by turning it over to Tang's courier. We'll give you one more chance to reclaim it.
Do not fail this time. Be one with the undying dragon, and you'll have its powers.
Tang, Master knew it. How am I supposed to get there?
You will be provided with a new avatar. Use this one with more care than the previous one. Now go.
That was surreal. Like these diamondbacks. With these guns and the aid of the gods, I'll reclaim the artifact in no time. Time to cap this.
Yeah, Drake just jumps out a window and fucking dies. Also, yes, the compression on these cutscenes is... it's as bad as you think it is. It is... that is just how it is. That was another thing that was alluded to in the interview that I did. That just idles compression on these. Also, I'm sorry if this is, like, deafeningly loud, but this is a very particularly loud level. It's a chase level. We're going to be on some city streets, and whenever there's cars at play, the mice will play. Or is that when the cat's away? Never was good with idioms. Or is that even an idiom? Is that just a saying? Don't mind me, don't listen to me. Why would anyone even listen to me? Is it established where this takes place? In the comic, I believe it is. And I think it's Cotton Kong. Oh. I almost messed up and fell to my death there, but I recovered it. There is fall damage in this game, and it can be quite brutal. Let's see, there's some speedrunning strats I could do. You know, this master of the game that I am. But I'm not gonna do them because, one, I'm bad at them. And two, you know, you want to see the whole game. You want the whole experience. You want the whole... all 99 of those dragons. Clearly there's fall damage, he died. Yes, thank you, Sean! You'll notice that a lot of missions begin with you facing the completely wrong direction, which I think is really funny. Alright, now if you're an amateur, you wait for the elevator here. Oh, shit. Don't mind me, I already messed up. Can I restart this level? Can I just... because now I actually do have to wait for the elevator. I was gonna like do this whole like, you know, if you're an amateur you can do this, but if you're a pro like me, all I wanted to do was run up the wall here, which I can't even do now because I've cursed myself. Ah, come on. Look, I swear there's a way to not have to wait for the elevators in this mission. And damn it, I'm gonna do it if it's the last thing I do. Hey, there we... No! So close. Yeah, there we go. Got it the first try. Got it in one. Now, you may notice that the wall running is a little bit finicky at times, but that being said, as imprecise as it is, there's a lot of things you can do with it. There's a lot of neat tricks you can pull off, stunts you can pull off. Oh my god! And every time you die in this game, you get sent to this screen over here, where the statues berate you for dying. I just like to use it as an excuse to mess around with physics in that little invisible walls in that room. Okay, we got it this time. Trust on this. Yes, Drake needs to feed off souls to live, so you could say he's like a soul vampire of sorts. I usually get this first try. This is brutal. This is like killing my self-esteem, my confidence right now. just take the elevator. That's so disheartening. But yeah, I'm a contender. I would argue that the potential for speedrunning this game with what the wall running allows you to do, there's definitely something to it. Someone more competent than I am, hopefully, figure this out at some point. Now, I'm unsure of like what the mechanic is in this room, what the trigger actually is that makes the game progress. Because it's not like jumping up to this door, I don't think. Yeah, at some point, an explosion goes off, and that's the end of the level. So I think it might just be like a timer that you have to wait for the tick down.
Again, he disappoints us.
So, this is the envoy of the gods? Who chose him?
You did.
You again. Is this the end?
Hardly. It has just begun.
At least this time you had a colorful exit. We are amused. The courier's name is Wang Chun, and he is working off a debt to Serpent Eye Sun. Fortunately for you, Chun has a weakness. He is a compulsive gambler.
He has stopped at the house of the Dreaming Cloud for a game of electric mahjong on his way to deliver the artifact. He is losing, but there's time for you to get there. He still has his pants.
Once again, fate deals you a winning hand. Free the dreamers of their nightmares and feed the undying dragon their souls. Then reclaim the artifact.
There'll be plenty of time to pursue the ghost that assassinated your master once you're done.
Somehow I doubt I'll ever be done feeding the undying dragon.
This time, you must be more careful. Motivation, that's all there is to it. Again, we will provide you with an avatar. This is starting to drain even our power. Are you ready to turn dreams into nightmares? Now go!
House of the Dreaming Cloud, I'm your wake-up call.
Man, Drake is such a badass. I love him. He tries so hard. Okay, so this is where we get the ability to draw in souls, which means they can sort of effectively put like a homing on the soul that people draw. But it also means that these red souls that do damage and stun you also get drawn towards you. And also, you have to be holding it down when you kill the enemy, so basically, like, you have to hold the key down the entire time you're playing the game. You may not have even heard any of that, because that room is so goddamn loud, but I do like how the glass sort of hovers in place here, by the way. We got some disconnected glass that I like to show off here. Whatever, they were trying. You know, they're trying to do something here with something stylized. You know, you gotta appreciate their moxie. You gotta appreciate the efforts. Even if the execution is a little long. Okay. So this is the first of the few boss fights in this game. I want to get that health if I can. This might not go well. Yeah, well, there we go.
alone won't save him or us.
Come on, let's get on top of it before this goes... Yeah, there we go. Last second.
Again.
So yeah, every time you die, you have to go back to that screen, wait a requisite 10 seconds, watch the cutscene for the mission play again, unless you decide to skip it, and then, only then, can you retry the mission. Maybe not the most intuitive design, maybe not the most, you know, best flow I've seen for retrying in a video game, for continuing in a video game, but... Okay. This time I'm going in with a bit more health. This time I won't get caught in the trap of getting chomped on by the dog monsters. Okay. And this time I'm also going to do an additional strategy and get on top of one of those pillars in a short while. Oh, never mind. I'm just going to die again, aren't I? Wait, no. By Jove, I think I've got it. Except they got into a spot that I can't quite shoot at. Oh, there we go. Alright. Smooth sailing from here. This is the only boss I really need to cheese like this. A lot of them have actual patterns. This guy just has a bunch of hitscan attacks that I don't want to deal with. And also a crazy amount of health. Oh, no! Man, I'm just having no luck. I think maybe it's the talking while playing the game. I'm going to blame it on that. I'm going to blame it on the fact that I'm commentating while playing. I'm getting distracted. I'm not giving my full concentration, my full admiration, my full consecration to Drake. He's not getting the 100% of me that he deserves. He's only getting 99%. Problem. So if you get hit by the little doggy guys, they'll take some chunks off. And also these red things will lock you in place, definitely open you up to some hits. Okay. This time I think I've actually got it. Because he's struggling to get bullets over this desk. So if I just stand here and sort of do my right click, left click. Try saying that fast. It's trickier than I thought. Hey, there we go. And again, we got on the first try, flawless, as per usual. That's what you come to expect from Bad Game Hall of Fame.
The house of the Dreaming Club was a lucky shot. Since he saved me some time, I'll spare his life. Jun, we've been expecting you.
Tong,
for quite a while now.
Did you see if he had the artifact?
No. What did Tong say about that call from the house of the Dreaming Cloud? Man, if that snitch was right about him losing it to Pac, he's as good as dead.
I better hurry before they kill him. If he lost the artifact, I must know to whom. I'll just let these guys leave.
And this is the first mission with key cards in it, and also a sort of open area. So I'm gonna take the speedy route through this, because the more you dilly-dally, the more you linger in these stages, the more chances you have to die, and every time you die, that's another time you have to restart the level from the beginning. Which even me, in my infinite love and forgiveness for this game, I have my limits. And this game does like the full like Doom keycard system, where it's three keycards, red, green, and blue. Couldn't even swap one of them out for yellow, just to try and hide what the influence here is. One thing the AVGN definitely got right is that weapons besides the pistols are kind of useless. There is actually an improved pistol we'll get later, but that's still a pistol, so I'm still technically right when I say that pistols are a superior choice of weapon in this game. That's the girl that appears in the load screen for this level. I don't think she's like a main character or has any like significant role in this. She's not a character in the comic. Alright, so we have the blue key card now, and we gotta find the blue key card door. I know that's the wrong way. It's easy to get lost here because the walls here are obviously very same-ish. So when you have like a lot of similar geometry in a level, and you're looking for milestones or just sort of differentiating things, unique signposts that let you know you're going in the right direction, you're making forward progress. So yeah, to someone who hasn't maybe played this game 5 or 10 times like I have, you can get lost in these levels a bit easier, I reckon. Which is why I say that they tossed up those green arrows so often in this game. I feel like they wanted to probably implement more signposting and, you know, natural level design that sort of flows from one area to another. But again, it's just one of those things that probably didn't have time for. At least that's what I want to believe, that given a couple more months, this game would somehow be the game of my dreams that I really want it to be. Quote man commenting that this is absolutely the kind of level that their horrific sense of direction does not play well with, and yes, I'm also bad at video game direction on many occasions. I am let it be put on the record that I hate labyrinth levels in games. There we go, by the way. A little bit of a cheese there. Completely unnecessary. That guy's not particularly difficult.
The owner wanted. It was Puck.
You lie. I killed him. I want the truth.
I lost it to Puck, but he isn't human. So you couldn't have killed him.
Serpent Eye is well ahead of me. I must return to the Dreaming Claw.
How many can there be? Why won't you just die?
No. No one's alive. This baby should be no time.
Thugs. This is a one-way street.
To hell.
There's a lot to digest in that cutscene. But no time for that, we gotta jump into the level. Where we're now up against a roving biker gang. And this one dude can eat like 3 clips, 3 magazines. I hope no one in the chat minds if I accidentally say clip instead of magazine. Hope we don't have any firing range folk in here. I think it's also in this level that we can get access to the shotgun for the first time. Which a shotgun at close range actually does seem to do a wallop on you.
He is not immortal, you know.
Hey! This level apparently has some of the worst out-of-bounds errors. I've never been able to find them personally, which is unfortunate, because I would love to get out-of-bounds in this game. But I've just never had that much luck with bugs and glitches in this game. I know it has a reputation for being notoriously buggy and just jank as all hell, and the jank is certainly there, but I've never been able to bug it out completely. Ooh, that was really loud. That was real crunchy. Again, apologies for anyone whose ears may be susceptible to this sort of stuff. Mine certainly are. But I really wanted to get the shotgun there. What I really love is how the physics objects operate at a lower frame rate than the game does. It's something you see in a lot of like mid-2000s games running on modern computers with frame rates that were maybe faster than ever intended, where, you know, the game's running at 60 plus and the physics are you know, slated for like a 30, for a cap 30 that they might have expected the game to run at more traditionally, or sometimes even like 20. So you get this weird disconnect. I'm trying to think offhand of other games that sort of suffer that, but nothing comes to mind offhand. I'll catch you later, Atlas Shrugged. That Atlas Shrugged, by the way, one of the streamers on our Game and Love Twitch team. So, you know, check him out when the stream is done today, or check out whoever's streaming, whoever may be. There's always someone playing something on our Twitch team. Even if it's just me playing Drake, he of the 99 Dragons. Oh, come on! I thought I was in a safe spot in the back of that truck, but sure enough, there's no cure for stupidity. It swung right around and crushed me, which means we gotta hear those boxes explode again. Okay, let's just speed through this. I don't think I need the shotgun. I don't think I need to even fire a single shot for the most part. Let's see how far we can take this. Okay, the trigger for the wrecking ball is, or whatever it is, isn't going off, so I guess I do actually have to kill some enemies here. I assume that most of the game, like, can just be like, you can just move forward without having to worry about, like, specific killing amounts of enemies or whatever. Can I just jump over this? No, that's an invisible wall, so I guess I straight up do have to kill all the enemies here. Trying to save some time and I'm just wasting it. Okay, and this is the wrecking ball, so if that can just come out, that'd be perfect. Thank you. I'm glad that didn't kill me in one. And that's the one that killed us. Oh wait, no, that's the one we can hide inside of for safe refuge. And one will probably this one, if I keep my eyes on it. Oh, nope, I think it was a completely different one. Here we are. And we are real close now to the end of the level, so we'll hopefully never have to see any of this again. Now that guy's a real charmer. The Last Laugh is a great mission name for this. And this is a boss fight with a gimmick, where if you shoot him, you're not doing any damage to him. You're seeing the metal popping up. That's because you're shooting the ball and chain that he's swinging around. It's not telegraphed great. And sure enough, the real issue here is dealing with all the other enemies peripherally who are shooting at you. So we'll probably take care of them first, and then I'll show you the secret to defeating this boss real easy-like. Sorry if I go quieter any points during this. There are times where I need to concentrate, kind of. You know, what do they call, like, the AGDQs and the SGDQs and all the games done quicks versus the concentration mode, or... Anyway, I think that's... Okay, now that should be everybody. Alright, so what I'm going to want to do here is get underneath the parking garage. And now every time he attacks, he will get caught on the ceiling. Or not every time, most of the time. And that'll give us our opportunity to attack. I think he can also get caught in, like, walls here with his chain. He didn't even do an attack. He just walked up to me. He was standing behind me when that happens.
He is not immortal, you know.
Very curious. Some of the levels have longer time limits, yeah. Some of them are shorter. Some of the chase missions, I think there's maybe one more. It's hard for me to remember offhand. We'll get there when we get there, as they say. think I'm just gonna ignore the enemies on top here, because I'm not going up on the roof. I'm also gonna not use the shotgun, because it wasn't doing us any favors. It'd be nice if this dude got his... Oh, there we go. Yeah, I see. You see there was a moment where he got stuck in the wall. Also, another thing I should note, you can't reload your weapons until you just drop them and toss them for new ones. And there we go. It didn't have much health at all, as it turns out.
Serpent Eye should have had plenty of time to wreck the Dreaming Cloud. Things are heating up. It's time for me to end the party.
Most badass shot in the game. Doesn't even look back at his explosion that he made. So you know he's hot shit. And does this bring us back to the nightclub? Yes, this is the second time in the game that they are recycling a level within like a few levels of it initially appearing. You know, I haven't used the slowdown time at all. I should probably do that, right? Okay, let's never use that again, because it's completely useless. You know, that's the thing, is that, you know, at a certain point it slows down to such an interminable speed that... You know, you're not getting any benefit. You're not moving faster in the slow motion. You're not, like, outmaneuvering people. You're just sort of slowing down with them. I guess I can't jump on that while it's in motion. I'm learning new things about this game. Who the fuck
is
it?
Is this our last chance?
What the term is length of the slowdown? So there's a button you hold down that as long as you hold it down, it slows down. And the longer you hold it down, the slower it gets and the longer it takes to get back to full speed. And you recharge that meter, by the way, by killing the enemies. Filling up that meter in the bottom left. The amount of stuff you can just straight up avoid in this game, the amount of conflicts you can just walk away from. Again, just points to my theory that this is a speed game just waiting to be discovered by a larger community. Alright, this is another boss fight where the tell isn't necessarily, like, spelled out clearly. But if you notice, this dude is pulling from electricity, shooting electricity at us. And you can occasionally see some of the bolts being pulled from these sockets in the ground. So shooting him won't do any damage until you actually shoot all these outlets on the ground level. And that will open up the damage. Oops. Yeah, well. That'll happen. He can still pull electricity even if he's not plugged in. So he can still fire off a shot that'll zap ya. Railgun style. What's interesting about the health overfill is that when you do have it above 99, you can do this ultimate attack. You can unleash the dragon. So to speak, as Sisko would call it. And it's one of the more powerful attacks in the game, if not the most powerful, actually. Yeah, it has to be the most powerful, as a matter of fact. Alright. But, you know, with the slow tick down, obviously, you need to, like, be at full health and then some in order to use it. And then when you use it, you immediately go back down to 99 health, and... It's just hard to pull off. It's hard to have in reserve. It would be easier if they just tied it directly to the meter in the bottom left. Like, you need to have a full charge of that, rather than making it a health overcharge ability. You know, I'm just thinking out loud here. I'm just armchair game designing. There we go. And I'm just gonna stand by here, wait for all the animations to play out. Being extra cautious. And I say that as even as I take damage because I go in too soon. Because I am nothing if not, like, untrue to my word as I'm speaking it. Do as I say, not as I do. Okay. Am I missing an apple? Looks like he was still not taking damage. Wait for it. Mission complete. Yeah, it looked like I died. It looked like I fucked up again. But nope, that's exactly how it's supposed to go.
Almost too easy. The soul portal artifact is mine.
Oh, the pain.
Pain. Yes. That's how a human knows he's alive. Perhaps there's still some humanity left in you. This time, you did not lose your avatar, but were summoned here. You have no time for cat and mouse games.
No time? Let's not waste more here.
Very well. Servant's Eye fishermen have captured the albino orca and brought it to the fish factory at Dock 12.
This is where Serpent Eye will deliver the artifact to complete his bargain with Tang.
And a ritual will be performed to charge the artifact with the energy of the whale's soul.
You must disrupt the ritual and reclaim the artifact.
They mention an albino whale here. The stench of death. Like, we're supposed to know what this is? Like, it's supposed to be meaningful in some capacity? Like, it's referenced in the comic book or something? It's not. As far as I'm aware, it's just completely out of nowhere. It's just some lore they're making up on the spot and expecting us to be completely buying into, so... But yeah, from what I gather, you know, this whale, big whale means a big soul, I guess. And they want to infuse the artifact with as many souls as possible so they can open some sort of interdimensional gateway to the spirit realm? I think that's the plot of this game. I think that's the plot of this video game that I've played multiple times. It's hard to say. Oh, come on. Come on now. I'm trying to do you good here, Drake. I'm trying to do you a favor, and you're making it difficult for me to recommend you with all this janky-ass collision. What are you doing, dog? Alright. And these dudes are built like brick shithouses. That's another thing about this game, is that I kind of wish enemies took about, you know, half the amount of bullets to kill as they do in final products. And the only reason I'm even taking the time to kill these guys is just to have like a generous bit of a health buffer. This room, I think, you're supposed to do some, like, fancy timing or something. I was gonna say, we shouldn't even bother, like, what? Well, I don't need to do that. Well, I would need to waste my time doing that, but... As you can see, there's a very good reason why you should do that. Cambertian asks, do you get other weapons? Yes, there are some other... There are machine guns that are largely useless. A shotgun, which only works at, like, point-blank range to be useful. The pistols are probably the most effective weapon in the game. And, you know, pistols are cool as hell. I mean, John Woo, come on. Stranglehold. Also, a lot of these enemies are just straight-up not dropping weapons. I did find the revolver here, though. So we can go ahead and use this for a minute. Dual revolvers are cooler than dual handguns, so... Did I forget to grab the key card? Oh, Cass, you goof. Alright, this time I'm not gonna waste any time, because I have 95 health, and... The only reason I need to go up here is for the red key card. I think if we jump, we can dodge most of the damage here. I think it's mostly that dude shooting at us that got us last time. And these guys, I think I might actually have to kill. I might not have to. Yeah, let's see if I can just progress without that. It's my patented triple wall jump technique. And yeah, you may recognize this guy. His name is Serpent Eye, because he only has one eye. I don't know how that really plays in him being a serpent, but... maybe he tried to get, like, a snake transplant, the snake eye transplant to his other eye, and it didn't work out entirely, so... that's my best guess moving forward. Oh, this could go badly. I'm completely stuck in here. Oh.
Prove you're worthy of your fate.
Oh, by the way, I should mention, the stream. Last stream we did, when I played a bunch of Gamecom games, I believe I said that stream was sponsored by Doritos brand Mexican soda. This stream is actually sponsored by a different sponsor. Doritos did not care for the association with the Tiger Gamecom. I got some angry legal letters. So this stream, instead, is sponsored by Vanilla Coke. Not just regular Coke, it's Coke with vanilla in it. For when you want vanilla, but you also want a Coke, it's Vanilla Coke. That's the ad read. It is also my favorite soda, I think. I'm not just saying that because they're definitely sponsoring the show. I'm not just saying that because I'm getting paid, like, buku bucks to talk about Vanilla Coke. So our health is so low that I might as well just die here, because I'm gonna die in the fire room, right? I mean, that's how this is gonna go. Okay, let's see if we play this cautiously, let's see what happens. Ah, good enough. I will play kind of conservatively in here. I'm going to try to bait these guys out one at a time, as opposed to getting caught in the corner and picked to death by their hooks. Amazing how the guy on the sentry gun has less health than these guys who are just melee dudes walking up to you. Not amazing, surprising, really. Oh, I messed that one up. I messed everything up. Alright, this is where we start to see cyborg enemies who, again, take quite a few shots in some cases. Luckily, I think we can completely ignore these guys relatively safely. And I mean it this time. Should just be a door somewhere around here. There we are.
Back because of a woman, Banshee. She's the right hand of Tang.
That woman just... cold stone.
The Tang Undertakers are moving the body of the master from...
Drake, by the way, yes, you did hear right. He said cold stone as opposed to stone cold.
Drake.
So, while I'm sponsored by Vanilla Coke, Drake and the 99 Dragons is sponsored by Coldstream, Cold Stone Creamery's vanilla ice cream, I imagine. Old body on sight.
So this is how it really feels to be undead.
Master?
Hey, remember those first few levels? Remember that one level we had to play multiple times? Well, the same tile set at the very least. It's not the same level geometry. And here we go. Here is the improved pistol, so now you can finally see me change to a different weapon. You may also notice my player model has some holes in it because this is our original body. This is the one that we lost at the beginning of the game. So you can actually see through the holes. I don't know how well that shows up on stream at this resolution, but... again, just a nice little touch. Now this is one level where I really don't want to die in. Because this elevator... having to sit through this animation every time we restart is rough as guts. Luckily, I think I more or less have this down to a science. It's just a matter of not getting greedy, not letting the fall damage get the better of you. I would like more missions like this in the game, where you're sort of, you know, using the verticality to your advantage, because I feel like there is a strong vertical game here with your wall running and the options you have for maneuvering. And having these jetpack enemies is kind of fun. Now, this bit's a bit tricky. We can wait for this elevator to go down. There's a trick you can do where you can sort of wall run to, you know, mitigate and negate some of the damage you would take. Those poles in the distance. But again, I just want to play it safe for stream. Oh, and I fucked up. Didn't die though, took 60 damage. And that will kill me. I think what happened there was I forgot where I was going. I momentarily forgot which route I'm supposed to take, and I just sort of took a jump. I took a fall that was going to end no other way but poorly for me. Which unfortunately means we have to sit through that aforementioned elevator sequence again. Never mind. We'll just get killed by those pistols, because they pack a wallop, even when not in our hands. That's how you can tell they're a straight upgrade on our Diamondback pistols, as I think Drake refers to them as. Yeah, it's rough. 30 health. Yeah, we'll give it a shot. I got really good luck the first time through, but... where I took out both those guys and didn't take any damage, but... if you wait long enough in here, you see them toss some grenades. There we go. And I think that's a grenade launcher that we picked up there. Yep. I don't know if I ever really use this gun. If I really attempt to. Especially in this level, where it just seems like completely useless, except for the fact that it fires so rapidly. And of course, I was just... Why did I think anything else would happen there? I was playing with fire, and I got burnt.
Seeing you here again.
Play with grenades, you get blown up. I can see why the fire phrase is the one that caught on, not the grenade one. There is no difficulty levels in this game, continuous noise. This is just the game. It is what it is. We should have better luck this time, so. So things are looking up for us. I would say, by the way, we're about halfway through the game, conservatively. And again, I just want to reiterate, I like this game. I'm a fan of it. I think it has some good ideas that maybe aren't executed perfectly, but generally I find it charming. How much damage do we take? Like 15? Okay. Acceptable. Okay. Ah, dang it. I was hoping I could run across the wall and that would mitigate a lot of the fall damage there, but I kinda borked that one up. That's fine though, we're still alive. We might not be for long, though. Hey, what do you know? Just by the skin of our teeth. Fuck!
Death won't set him free.
When was Halo 2 announced? I mean, it was announced early. I mean, when did they start showing trailers for it? I want to say, like, circa 2003, around the same time they're showing trailers for GoldenEye Rogue Agent. Because, you know, GoldenEye Rogue Agent took a lot of that dual-wielding design from that. Allegedly. I mean, they only had, you know, one of the lead designers, director of design for Halo 1 contribute to GoldenEye Rogue Agent, so... But allegedly, they stole the idea from Halo 2 to have dual weapons in Rogue Agent. Despite just having the same creative DNA. But anyway. I'm thinking of other dual weapon games. I mean, remember, Marathon. Bungie's Marathon. Just can't stop thinking about Bungie right now. You know, had its dual wielding pistols. I wouldn't necessarily say that this is, you know, a function you can attribute to Halo 2 in terms of inspiration. I mean, it's more just the fact that The Matrix had, like, dual wielding. That John Woo movies that this is very clearly inspired by have heroes wielding dual-wielding Beretta 92FSs, as is the trope in his movies. There's also Max Payne, which is being addressed right now in the chat. Which, yeah, I think that's another one of the obvious ones. Okay, this time we didn't take as much damage from the fall. 40, I think I can work with. See, that's the problem with this level, is that you sort of get to the point where, like, you're wanting to speed through it. Which is just a fool's idea, because the more you rush through it, the more damage you end up taking from these falls, and the more difficult it is to actually survive them. Here we are, this is the final elevator. I was kind of half expecting to die the second I touched down in this elevator. So now we gotta wait for this to go down. I may have screwed up. I may not have enough health to actually survive the next enemies that come up down here. They shoot some grenades at you when they can be. Or I think the strategy is to shoot grenades at them, and I somehow did not pick up the grenade launcher, so this could be very troublesome. But I think I can also sort of... Oh, I was so close! You can't see, but I'm making a hand motion that says I was this close!
Our last chance.
With pulling the souls towards you, I mean, that's what I did there. I pulled that soul towards me in the from the guy around the corner. But, yeah, it can only get you so far, unfortunately. You have to be holding the button down the entire time as well, which for me is the E key. I feel like that's probably the best find I'm going to come up with for it. What I messed up was I needed the grenade launcher so I can bounce grenades off the wall down that hallway and take that dude out from afar without putting myself in his line of sight. So as long as I remember to grab a grenade launcher this time, I think we'll be okay. And as long as I get good luck with the fall damage and don't get completely... don't break my legs. As long as I still have a foot to hop on, we should be okay. Let's See, that's our grenade launcher. I want to get down on that platform. And yes, well, let's play conservatively. I'm going to play ultra conservatively, which means waiting for this elevator to go back down, which may take a while, but better to wait now than to have to replay this a dozen more times due to my impatience. So I ask that you bear with me. Yeah, let's swap out these pistols for the improved models. So how's everyone's spooky season going? How's everyone's All Halloween month festivities going? Anyone watching any horror movies? Anyone doing that whole debacle, that whole charade? I've been meaning to watch some movies with my roommate, but we haven't been in a horror mood as of late. I've got a few movies on a list, though, that I'm looking to picking up. I finally want to watch Alice, Sweet Alice, the, was like 78 horror movie. I'm more into psychological horror sort of stuff than I am, I'm not a big Gorefest fan, let's say. Okay. Now, this is where... Oh no! Oh, we are in hell, folks. We are in hell, and this level is our limbo. This is our purgatory. I thank you for sticking through this. I thank those of you who... We're still here against all odds for reasons I don't know. For reasons that are beyond me. I would have given up on this stream. If I wasn't one playing the game, but if I was one who was contractually obligated to be here, I'd have ducked out by now. Oh, come on. I swear I'm not just, like, intentionally dying there, not trying to be this kamikaze. It's just... Sometimes the pistols hit, sometimes they don't. I feel like there's like a randomization element to whether bullets actually hit or not or do damage. I don't want to have to play this entire level just super slow and conservatively. I don't want to have to do that for the duration. Okay. Going up. Or is it down? It starts going down, then it goes up. You can tell I've got the drive to really get this done now, because I'm just gonna shut up and play the game at this stage. Watch out, we only have 8 minutes and 50 seconds left on the clock! I think the timing's gonna work out where this should start going down in a couple seconds. I would hope. Thank the Maker. Let's bring these weapons out so we can get some full clips going. Preparedness? And look at those models go. Look at those physics in action. Okay, that's as low as it goes. Now, I think... Oh, that was too much damage. I can mitigate a little bit of it. I think 35 should be enough. What year did Hitman 2 Silent Assassin come out? Because that was one of the first games I really like remember putting a heavy emphasis on its ragdolls, where you could like, you know, staple people to the walls with a nail gun or whatever. I remember that being like a really big like trailer selling point, big feature of the game. See, this is what I'm worried about. That dude in the back is gonna get me. Because, like, one shot, that did 45 damage. Which is why I've been, like, trying to get as much health as possible going into that section. And yeah, it's all thanks to those pistols that these guys are wielding. And again, the damage on them is completely random, where it can do as much as... it can do as little as 25 and as much as 50-plus damage with one shot.
One with the Undying Dragon. And you'll have its powers.
If anyone has any questions, by the way, about not just this game, but any video games, any bad video games, or I'm happy to answer those. I am nothing if not a veritable well of information on bad games, I like to think. I like to pretend. The Dave Meltzer of bad games, that's the title I'm going to try to work towards. And, you know, we don't have much else going on right now in this game, in this stream, so now's as good a time as any for me to distract myself from the hell that I'm currently enduring. I gotta open up my Ask.fm again. Or not Ask.fm. Ask.fm doesn't even exist anymore, does it? Curious Cat, that's what all the kids are on these days. I don't even want to use it to answer personal stuff. I just want to answer these weird questions about, like, video game history. I want to solve all the mysteries. Scorching the earth. Oh, no. Oh, phew. I was worried that grenade was gonna get me, that all my grenade spamming was gonna bite me in the butt, but... There is a reason why I'm doing that. I'm at this point, I'm trying to just any enemies that may be hovering around down there. I'm hoping that just the collateral of these explosions somehow makes their way over to them while they're out of view. See, I just happen to eat a rocket or two. How low does this go? Right about here-ish. Yeah, as long as I jump on that hook, if I land on that hook, we should be okay. And not take too much damage. This is where I could potentially mess things up if I get greedy and I jump down from here. Okay, now I know I can drop down onto that. Except it's pointless to do so. Oh, did I mess up already? Oh, man. Yeah, I needed to transfer over to that section over there. You think if me, after having played this like a dozen times in the past 20, 30 minutes, that I would have caught on to that by now, gotten the sense of the geometry, but that's not me. Never knows best, never learns my lessons. I was about to ask if this elevator is going to start moving anytime in the next like millennium or so, but the wow effect on the Soul Collect is still one of the funniest things I've seen in a long time. I really love the onomatopoeia in this game. I think it's really charming and out of place. And I know they're trying to go for the whole comic book aesthetic, but with how gritty and dark this game is, mixed with, like, you know, bam, thud. It'd be like if you took, like, the 1960s Batman effects and just put them in the middle of the Dark Knight. If someone hasn't done that, someone do that. That's a viral video right there. That's a 10 million view video for you. Just Dark Knight footage intercut with bow, bow. Hey, there we go! It's a miracle! Now all we have to do is not die in this room. Come on, Drake. Yes! It's a Halloween miracle. It's an October miracle. Oh, we can all collectively wipe our brows now. Wipe the sweat that's been forming.
Where are they taking him? Got to make it to that truck.
Soon, Master. Real soon.
I forgot about his little roll at the end of that one. Also, I want to apologize again for how long that took. And if it doesn't feel like I'm taking this particularly seriously. I am trying to progress. I am trying to finish this game. It's just a matter of I try not to let the little things stress me out about video games, about life. So when I take a while to get something like that done, when I struggle with something like that, I'm not, like, necessarily getting mad at it. I'm just kind of, like, rolling with the punches. As long as it may take. I think this is the only time we see this enemy in the game, and that's a shame, I guess? There's some MP5s up here. We'll give these a go. Just because I'm sure we're all sick of the pistols at this point. Even though I don't believe these are very effective. Aw, man. Yeah, I think if we were just using the pistol, that would have probably gone a bit smoother. I could probably do, like, machine gun one hand just to be laying down a constant spray and a pistol in the other. I think that's how I usually play the game, but I have reason to believe that is not very effective. I have reason to believe that the pistols, just on their own, are objectively the most convenient and useful weapon. I also have reason to believe we can skip this entire encounter. But yeah, hopefully as we get into the swing of streaming more regularly, just playing games for fun without doing too much pre-planning and whatnot, hopefully we'll sort of get into a flow, and hopefully you'll begin to see my sort of approach to this, which is I can't muster up the frustration, the madness to, like, really get, like, heated about games. I life isn't long enough for me to waste it being, like, you know, steamed about video games, so I'm gonna make the no screaming promise, the no shouting promise on this stream. I promise I will never yell at the video game in such a loud and scary way as to make everyone uncomfortable. We'll sort of take them at my own pace, as meandering and miserable as that may be in itself. This level requires waiting for these doors to sort of, there's a sequence, there's like a pattern. Oh, am I gonna be close enough? Did I mess up by walking so far back? No, just barely made it. Look at these bodies, by the way. These are all the corpses that are being submitted to Tang Industries and having their souls extracted. That's part of the story that I feel like doesn't get enough, like, attention, that sort of gets glossed over, that people in this universe are literally just shipping the corpses of their relatives and loved ones to this mega corporation for use in robots. Okay. My browser froze for a minute, and now I'm only coming back in. Why are you playing Sonic Adventure 2 now? I am not playing Sonic Adventure 2. I think that's... When we were playing Sonic Jam on the Gamecom last stream, I put Sonic Adventure 2 Battle as a joke for the category, but it should be Drake of the 99 Dragons. It should be. You may have to refresh your Twitch page, Video Game King. By the way, this is the Master's body and head and mind in this robot, in this boss fight here. Is what that cutscene was trying to convey that I was so rudely talking over. I'm not paying this game the due diligence and respect it deserves. Okay. I'm sorry that I completely glossed over the fact that it was a joke about the level design and that level from Sonic Adventure 2 Battle that has the big wind turbines. It was a coincidence because when I set up the stream, when I started streaming, we did have the category set as Sonic Adventure 2 Battles, so forgive me for getting my wires crossed there. So this is an exciting encounter. I don't know if you ever heard of this strategy, it's called Surface Strafing. It's been around in shooters for a while now. And it's very effective when the AI routines are... Literally, just a matter of like turning around, spinning in place, and trying to get a lock on you. Oh, some of them caught up to me. I think each of those rockets does like 5 damage, though. And by the way, you may think there's some gimmick with like, you know, the spray. Maybe you shoot these down to make the damage go by more quickly, but. By all indication, that's not the case. I think this is, you're just meant to endure however long it takes to destroy this robotic shell. There are some weapons hidden in this level on top of the balconies. Like, you can see, sort of, the machine guns up there, but as we've established, I'm fairly certain the pistols are the best weapons in the game, so I think this is as fast as this can be done. I'd love to check out the speedrun, see what their weapon recommendations are, see if they just use the pistol exclusively as I sort of would assume they would. But I did not watch that. Okay. I decided to mix it up a little bit at the end there. Because you can only circle straight for so long before you run out of mouse pad.
Master, I'll take you to the Serene Garden and your final rest.
Has someone close to you recently departed?
Hold on. Setting the Tang's TV campaign for the souls of the city makes sense. He must be stopped. Master, this is the Serene Garden. You can rest here. The Master of the 99 Dragons.
Yes, we see the body, but not his soul.
I'll bring back his soul, but first I'll take care of Tang. There it is, Tang Towers, the most secure building in the city. I hope Tang is working the graveyard shift. They say there's no way to get around their security. I wonder...
I do like this art here. I get a very Maltese Falcon vibe. A Humphrey Bogart with the two pistols from the poster for that movie. And then the little comic panel here. This is a stealth level by... I walked right into that one, huh? Just rounded that corner. So, as I was saying, this is a stealth level where we have to not trigger alarms. Reminds me of that one level in World Is Not Enough, the N64 version of that game, which is excellent, not the awful PS1 version. I was going to say, if there's any justice in the world, that one guy would get killed by the train. Okay, now, interesting thing about this. This is a... this was apparently a scene that was, like, very contested in development and quality assurance, where the progression here, they wanted to be telegraphed more clearly. So what we need to do is we need to go into this room, kill this poor doggy, who never did nothing to nobody. This is bullshit. Then we shoot this console. Now, when I step outside, you're going to see a little animation. And reportedly, when the QA tester I interviewed was telling IdleFX they need to really tighten the sequence up. They sort of need to, like, you know, fix the telegraph, make it more obvious where you need to go in the level. IdleFX didn't understand the complaint about this level. Didn't understand what he was exactly trying to convey to them. So what they decided to do instead was add souls that come out of the trains when they collide. They assumed that's what the tester was trying to ask them to put in the game. Which is just so tasteless. Yeah, we're gonna assume that we just, like, killed a bunch of civilians. We're just trying to do their morning commutes. Yeah, so if you hit a certain amount of alarms, I think if you hit 4, that's an instant fail for the mission. As I watched in an irate video game, irate gamer video I was watching earlier today, 4 hits and it's instant death. But that's from the Castlevania episode, by the way. Why I was rewatching that? Someone posted it on Twitter. Just as, like, an example of, like, man, remember when this was, like, a thing on YouTube? Oh, that's the first alarm. The spotlight, I didn't know if that was gonna be a trigger or not. But yes, when you do activate the alarm, you do get these ninjas who come out to try and assassinate you. So, you will try to avoid doing that in the future. Also, it's a lovely sound. I hope that plays for the rest of the mission, for the rest of the game, even. Oh no, it went away, what a shame. That was an easy one. I wish you could shoot these mines from afar and just blow them up, but that is not the case. Alright, there we go. Ah, put a sock in it, buddy. Can't you see we're being stealthy here? Can't you see we're going inconspicuous style, incognito? Alright, so we want to go up there. There we go. I'm sure I had opportunities to do that a bit quicker, a bit sooner, but we've learned what happens when I get impatient, when I just try to rush through things, so I'd like to say I learned my lesson. I know I haven't, but it's nice to think that I have. Hey! Got it in one. Not that it even mattered. If I even triggered the alarm there, I would just be able to hit the trigger there anyway.
This elevator should take me straight into the heart of Tang Towers. Going up.
I think that, if I remember correctly, and I'm pretty sure I do, that's the only mission with stealth mechanics, and that's a shame, because they could have done more to just add more variety to these mission types. There's a decent variety as it is. They do a decent enough job of cloaking the fact that every mission is effectively just, you know, the same running, gunning. That's the thing I look for in video games, is that if you can make it look like you're doing a variety of different objectives and tasks, that's all the better for your video game. You can never suffer from trying to, you know, massage and hide your gameplay, the repetitiveness of it, with sort of extraneous objectives and mission variation. I'm just gonna ignore those sentry guns if I can. Nope, I sure as hell can't. What guns are these? Micro SMGs? Ah, we're gonna die anyway, right? So. I don't think I was supposed to. Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot that some of the bottomless pits in this game, they'll just toss you back up as sort of like a pity thing. And that just so happens to be one of them. Probably because it's a level where you are meant to fall down so many holes that they feel like bad for maybe potentially misleading players and making them think that's a place you're supposed to go when you're not. There are some later levels where you will see a sort of similar recovery system. Where the game takes pity on you again. Now, this is a bit of a tricky one for me. This for me to figure out how to progress in this room initially. It's a very like specific timing thing where you have to do a wall jump here, and let's see if we can figure it out. Let's see if I remember what I'm doing here. If I can do this without taking damage. Nope. No, sure enough I can't. Maybe if I jump on top of these. Yeah, I think this is gonna do it. Wait for it to be at the bottom. Okay, there we go. That wasn't as... well.
Is this our last chance?
Nothing ever goes right for Drake. Poor Drake. Woe is he of the 99 dragons. But yeah, you know, in this level you can at least see that they're starting to play around with some of the jumping and the physics and whatnot. The mechanics of, you know, using your navigation techniques, using your maneuvers. There's one level that takes place in, like, the city streets that is, I think, is particularly good about that. Where you can use it, like, skip large portions level. I think we actually fell through the fan blades there. I don't know if that did damage to us. Let's see, I'm at 86 now, but... Okay, this time, as long as we take care of these sentry guns, I feel like we're not gonna take too much more damage there. Oh god, I did it again! This is only 10 health there. I sort of slipped up, I think. Also, I hate to have to ask this, but can someone send a message in the chat? Because I don't know if a connection stuff is necessarily working out at the moment. Is there a chance I may have lost network connection? I think we're okay, yeah. Sorry about that. It was just a thing where I saw the last message from Video Game King mentioning that he was having difficulty clipping stuff, and I worried that might have meant that something was happening with the stream, but it's totally fine. If things are fine, things are fine. Soon. A very special one at that. You know, for some reason I do not remember this hallway at all. Just weirdly. I feel like I remember most levels in this game and most sections from most levels, but for whatever reason that just felt like a complete like blind spot in my peripheral memory. Am I gonna need to kill all these dudes? Oh man. Ain't that a stinker.
Once again, he returns.
Man, oh man. Okay, at least I feel like we can play this level pretty fast and loose up to a certain point. So let's hopefully not linger too long. Just as soon as I can get this jump, this basic jump I've already done like a dozen times before in playing this. Maybe if I do single jump here, walk up the wall. Nope, I didn't jump quick enough. I think you get like 1, 2, 3, 4 steps, then you can do the jump there. Okay, cool. I'll remember that. I'll pretend I have that down to a science now and never run into issues with it again. Yeah, sunk into the fan blades again. This time I will not fall down this hole. Just walk to the other side of the room, all normal-like. Actually remembering to draw these souls in so I can get the maximum amount of health going in. Oh, I messed that one up. I think we even took some fall damage there? Or maybe electrical damage, it's hard to say. Alley-oop. Now that was some fall damage. Had my eye on it this time. The hallway. Oh, clicked outside the window for a brief second there. Hey, you know what? Give me a moment to catch my bearings, so. Worst things could happen there. I don't know if these dogs can actually hurt you. They were, like, taking bites out of me to, like, no effect there, so. We'll just pretend, like. Are you technically a boss? No, you take entirely too few hits. And there's two of you. You have a rocket launcher on your shoulder though, and that's pretty cool. Like hell, I get a rocket launcher on my shoulder. If I can legally carry that. Okay, now this is the boss. And the thing to know about this boss is, she can't hurt you because they accidentally forgot to program in, or that they messed up some aspect of the coding here that would make her able to hurt you. These dudes around her still can, so there's a very real chance that I could die right there. But it's totally worth it to demonstrate that she could hurt me, right? I'm Video Game King, I want to read this comment. I'm trying to critically analyze this game based on the stream. Now that I think about it, the focus on stringing together very clearly defined set pieces feels very in line with 2000 game design and its occasional emphasis on emulating film. Yeah, that's. I would absolutely argue that, yeah, absolutely, that most of these levels are pretty loosely strung together for the purpose of set piece. Which, you know, I have no problem with personally. I think games emulating action movies is fine. It's why I got a lot of mileage out of the Call of Duty series for a while. Just paying homage to World War II films at first, and then to, action movies later. I am a early Call of Duty defender, sad to say, up until about Advanced Warfare, I would say. I fell off around, dang, what game did I fall off around? Oh, Ghost, that's where I largely fell off that bandwagon. But, you know, sometimes you just need your, you know, morally reprehensible military jingoism propaganda game to get you through the day. And, you know, those games are nothing if not just a series of action set pieces barely strung together and heavily inspired by movies. I'll also say that I've been around the block, I've been around for a minute, which feels weird to say, but you know, like I was around Call of Duty since the beginning, and Which, yeah, that's like, what, like 2003 or 4 or 5, I think. So that's really saying absolutely nothing. I could and should say that, you know, my first game ever was Doom, or Doom 2, or Wolfenstein 3D. I couldn't tell you exactly which, because it was so long ago, but I feel like that's a better indicator of sort of what my history with this whole burgeoning medium is. Yeah, I don't think these dogs can hurt you. I think we're mostly immune to them. Okay, this time we are just going to blast this poor lady. Okay, this is not going great. We're gonna have to take care of these guys and... Man, this is, like, kind of stinks. I don't remember having this much difficulty with this ever. Man, that's a bummer.
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
Man, we're gonna go over the 2-hour time estimate I have. That's a shame. I really thought I could do it a lot quicker than that. You know, it's really awesome that you can't save this game. I mean, there's a save function, but for whatever reason, I've never been able to get it to work between the Steam version and the original PC version that launched in 2004. I've never been able to actually save configuration settings for the game, and I've never been able to save progress in the game, so whenever I've beaten this game, I've had to do it in a single sitting. And that 2-hour estimate came from, you know, when I recorded all the footage for the article on this game. People chiming in on what their first games were. I know some folks saying, GUI Heat specifically saying that they're trying to figure out what their first non-edutainment game is. And hell, you know, having an edutainment game as your first game, there's no shame in that at all. I know a lot of people whose first game was an edutainment title. I feel like the most common answer with our generation is something like the Super Mario Brothers Duck Hunt multi-pack, multi-cart, that was a pack-in with the NES. Pretty sure that's number one with a bullet. That's definitely the one I've seen the most personally. But you know me, I didn't start with consoles, I started with PC, and I eventually got my way into consoles, so... It's been a big game of catch-up. Codeman giving away their age a bit here with their first game being a 2600 game, so... So that'll be like, what, like circa, let's say they're... No, I'm not gonna guess what their age is, that's incredibly mean to do, and I don't mean to. Or not, like, not even mean, just like, I don't... Let me stop talking before I dig myself an even deeper hole at this stage. Why don't I? Don't mind me, I'm not good with my words. I apologize. I feel like we took a little more damage this attempt. I'll tell you what, this might be... If we can't beat the level on this run, I might call it a stream for now. I never promised to beat this entire game except for the parts where I totally did. But I think we can all sort of agree that I feel like I've given this game a fair shake. I think I've given this y'all a fair look at it. And you know, I have an entire article written about it on the badgamehalloffame.com. If any of y'all are so inclined as to read it, you know, you can get some more scoops. You can get an interview with a QA tester. But yeah, I don't feel like I ever want to do more than 2-hour streams. I feel like anything longer is a bit excessive for me personally. It's a shame I didn't get to my favorite level, the one I was mentioning before, the city streets, the one that really opens up the parkour abilities, but you know, you can always play this game on your own time. It's on Steam. It is $10, I think. And I would argue that it's absolutely worth it. You know, for as much as we're struggling here, I'm gonna blame it on show jitters. I'm gonna blame it on not having my full concentration. I'm gonna blame it on the rain. I'm gonna blame it on everything except me being bad at the game or the game being bad. You know what, I'd blame myself first before I blame the game for being bad. But that's how much I love it. So it's gonna have a special place in my heart. As me being the person who, like, will always defend this game. Being, feeling like the only defender at times. There's gotta be someone else out there, right? There's gotta be someone out there who's also, like, standing up for Drake. Who considers himself a member of their, of the 99 Dragons. If you're out there, bud, know you're not alone. I'm with you. Yeah, I just don't know how to negotiate these guys here, because they take so many bullets to kill. And again, I just like feel like I never had problems with this before. So whether that's show jitters, or whether it's just like incredibly bad luck? Huh. Yeah, well, I think I'm going to call it a wrap there, as a matter of fact. Very curious. It gets curiouser and curiouser.
This elevator should take me straight into the heart of Tang Tong.
I'll mention that the reason I switched weapons is because I thought maybe having the spray would be more effective on the crowd of enemies, so that way even bolts that are missing are hitting one of the six enemies that are chasing me around, but clearly that strategy was not working out. So I may need to reconsider that strategy in the future. If I ever get into speedrunning this game, someone's got to dethrone the record. A Video Game King mentioning, I think you remember saying that you tried learning Japanese before, but gave it up. Have you considered jumping back into Japanese to prepare yourself for Notorious Kusuge? No. Respect to anyone who can learn Japanese, who can learn a second language. My brain is just not wired for it. I would love to pick up a second language, and I have tried multiple times. And aside from the commitment issue, it's just a matter of, I just don't think my brain is particularly receptive to it. I think the time has passed me. I know it's easier to do that stuff when you're younger. And, I am not young. Sort of young. Young at heart. And I think that's what matters at the end of the day. Yeah, I'm gonna close out the game now. Sorry, Drake. Thought I would beat you today, but, not quite, evidently. So we'll take this to the final screen I had prepared here. Got our Nina Matsumoto Space Coyotal art, so generously contributed this to the article up on the website. They also had a second one that they did. They had a second sketch that is also up on the website as well. Had some outro music here. It's another dragon theme song. I'll take this time to thank you again for tuning in, even if this didn't exactly go according to plan, if we did not actually finish the game. I thank you for sticking with me for as long as you did. Again, I would have ducked out about, like, 20 minutes, not even 20, like, I would have ducked out, like, an hour and a half ago, in all honesty. But hey, you stuck around, which means, maybe you like my voice. That'd be nice. That's a nice thought. I'm gonna pretend that's the case, even though I personally hate my voice. Before I develop another language, I will develop a better voice for these streams, something a bit more, feminine, let's say, just as it's my taste. And hey, if any of you are showing up to the Portland Retro Gaming Expo, I will be there in a matter of some days. It's coming up. You'll recognize me as the doofus in a cowboy hat. I'll be hanging out with Stop Skeletons from Fighting and some other folk who I know who are attending the event, who are on the West Coast. So, you know, if you stop by, buy me a drink. Don't buy me a drink. I don't drink. I'll buy you a drink. We'll figure something out. Anyway, more streams, more loose sort of streams coming soon. What, coming Wednesday? That's when we have our stream of Zhu on the Grudge on the Wii. That's going to be a fun one. I'm going to put a bit more production and effort into that one. And that should be an interesting one. Getting some motion-tracked horror up. And we'll see if I can get through that game without getting scared by any of the jump scares. I know it's notorious for that, and for also being incredibly short, and also for being just really bad. But we'll see exactly how bad, and I'll try to get an article up on that before Halloween rolls around. Probably won't be able to meet that deadline. I've already struggled as it is to get an article done on XCOM Enforcer, which I've been writing about for about the past 2 months now, and not able to make entirely much headway. But you can see the work in progress draft for that up on the Patreon if you are one of the pledgers on there. I'm just grabbing this out way too long now. I'm sorry. I don't know when to end things. I don't know how to end things. So let's just end it by saying goodbye, and I'll be around again. Catch y'all later. Show up on the Discord if you're not a member of the Discord. There's a Discord. You should join the Discord. And check out other people streaming on the Game and Love team. I'm sure Arcade Punk Animal is playing something right now. Probably Let It Die. I know they've been playing a lot of that recently. I highly recommend anyone else besides me who streams, because everyone seems to be a bit more professional than I am. But maybe there's some charm in that. Who knows? And I just realized I've dragged it out for another minute now. I'm just going to keep talking until the heat death of the universe at this point. I'm just going to have to hit the stop streaming button in the middle of a sentence, because that's the only way this is ever going to